Hello, this is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and I'm here with a quick tip for optics for people who quickly want to composite with lighting effects that use alpha. Okay, so here is our original shot. We have our background and we have a text layer that I have already converted to a smart object. So let's come into Boris FX Optics. I will not apply previous effects. Let's just zoom in a little bit here. And I'm going to apply one of my favorite effects under the lighting category, and it's all the way over to the right, and it's ultra glow. This is absolutely the best glow effect you can find, and it's not just for text, but we do have some great presets that work really well on text. I'm going to use discotheque, and I'm going to change my color over to a cyan, and let's just crank up the brightness a little bit, shall we? Cool. I won't play around with any of the other controls. I'm just going to take it out like this and let's hit apply. And you'll notice that when we apply this in here, actually, this looks really pretty good. I like this. But you might notice some color shifts between what we saw in optics and what we're getting here. Now, when an object is over black and has alpha in optics, what's happening is that Photoshop is mistakenly pre-multiplying the result. And that's what's causing the color difference. But if we want the exact colors that are the same between Photoshop and optics, here's the easy way of doing it. Usually this isn't going to be a problem if you're just, you know, going to be screening this over the top afterwards, but let's spend 10 seconds getting the colors looking the same as they did in optics. All right, so I'm going to control or command click on my layer icon just to create a selection based off of the alpha channel. All right, let's come back into optics. I'm going to apply my previous filters. Yes, please. And I'm going to add another layer and I'm going to come into my color and I'm going to go to the channel switcher. And I've got a preset called RGB A white. All this does, it sets my channels over in the parameters to red is red, green is green, blue is blue, and alpha is one, which means it's completely opaque. So without this, you see we're getting an alpha generated by the ultra glow. With it, we're setting that alpha to 100%. All right, so this looks weird in optics. Let's hit apply. Take it back into Photoshop. Looks weird in Photoshop. But take a look at our text. We've still got these marching ants. So we've still got that selection saved. So I'm going to come down, create a layer mask, and take a look at that. We've now got that neon effect with the correct alpha channel applied exactly as we want it to with normal. And that's all there is to it. It literally takes 10 seconds. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and I'll see you again in another optics tutorial soon. If you enjoyed this quick tip, remember to hit the like button, and for hours of training across all the Boris FX products, head on over to borisfx.com.